friends, welcome to Friend of Health. So now we are in physiology part from AIPGET 2019 question paper. Hope you have done with the first question and you are cleared with CSF. If you have any doubt, please comment in the comment box. So far we have done with obstetrics and gynecology. So let's continue. So the question is, renin is secreted by. So the options are, A is gestaglomerular apparatus, B is collecting duct, C is loop of Henle and D is proximal tubule. So this question is very very simple. Answer, as you all know, the answer is gestaglomerular apparatus. But what you have to do here is, like, we should let us learn about gestaglomerular apparatus. This is one of the frequently asked question and it has so many interesting things to learn, and it is one of the easiest part in the kidney part, renal system. So whenever you read about renin, it is where you have, there are some important parts that you should know. For example, about the nephrons and the physiology of nephrons and about the parts of nephrons. So when you read about nephrons, see that you read about the reabsorption of sodium, potassium, calcium and all those things which are separate to the proximal convoluted tubule, distal convoluted tubule, etc. These are the frequently asked questions. For example, water, most of the water is reabsorbed from which part of the nephron? Answer is proximal convoluted tubule. So this question was one of the frequently asked questions. From renal system, they usually ask about the reabsorption of molecules or reabsorption of substance, electrolytes, etc., especially about proximal convoluted tubule. So please go and read about it and make proper notes about it. See, this is the structure of cross-sectional area of our nephron. So this is the proximal convoluted tubule. We have the renal corpuscle and we have our efferent arteriole here, then efferent arteriole here. So see here carefully, this part is called as gestaglomerular apparatus. It is gesta, understood? So it is gestaglomerular apparatus. What are the most important parts of gestaglomerular apparatus? So this is the area which is near to our distal convoluted tubule. So here is our distal convoluted tubule. So near to distal convoluted tubule, we have our macula densa cells and our gestaglomerular cells and our mesangium, that is called as extraglomerular cells. So macula densa, granular cells and mesangium, these three comprises, or these three together, is known as our gestaglomerular apparatus. So our renin is secreted from gestaglomerular apparatus. And see here, there are something which is very very important regarding our glomerular epithelium. There is something called podocytes. These podocytes are also one of the frequently asked question. What is the important cells that are present in the glomerular epithelium, that is called as podocytes? Now let me discuss something about our glomerular capillary. This glomerular capillary is almost similar to that of other capillaries, except with three things. See, these three things are very much peculiar for our glomerular capillary. These things include an endothelium for this, then comes a basement membrane. So this is composed of an endothelium, a basement membrane and also a layer of epithelium. So these three things are very very important when we consider about glomerular capillary. So it differs from that of a normal capillary by these three things. So together these three forms a filtration barrier. So glomerular epithelial membrane, so glomerular capillary is composed of these three layers, and together this form a filtration barrier. So that's it about glomerular capillary. There are chances to get question from this area. So let's see about little more about gestaglomerular apparatus. So as I told, the gestaglomerular apparatus consists of three types of cells. The first one is macula densa. This is a part of distal convoluted tubule of the same nephron. So they may ask, like, macula densa is a part of, maybe the options may come like distal convoluted tubule, proximal convoluted tubule, collecting duct, etc. So the macula densa is a part of distal convoluted tubule of the same nephron. The next comes is like gestaglomerular cells. This is also known as granular cells. So particularly when we see gestaglomerular renin is secreted from gestaglomerular cells. Here they have asked, here the question is like renin is secreted from, then the option they have given like gestaglomerular apparatus. But if we see particularly, renin is secreted from gestaglomerular cells. And next next comes extraglomerular mesangial cells. So these together forms just a glomerular apparatus. They may even ask a question like, what are the structures that are included in just a glomerular apparatus? So these are the three things which are included in our just a glomerular apparatus. So just a glomerular apparatus is a specialized structure formed by the distal convoluted tubule. This is also important. It is formed by the distal convoluted tubule and the glomerular efferent arteriole. It is located near the vascular pole of glomerulus, and its main function is to regulate blood pressure and the filtration rate of the glomerulus. So whenever you read about renin, please go back and read about renin angiotensin mechanism. It is very, very important for regulating our blood pressure. There are chances to get question from that part also, from where this angiotensin is secreted. So as we all know, angiotensin is a powerful vasoconstrictor. You have to read about it. So let's speak little bit about glomerular filtration rate. So glomerular filtration rate is one of the frequently asked question for most of the competitive examination. So just see about it. Normally the glomerular filtration rate is 180 liter per day. As we all know, the first and foremost function of urine formation is, first and foremost step of urine formation is the filtration of large amount of fluids that reaches the glomerulus. So how much it is filtered per day? So it is like 180 liter per day. That's it about glomerulus and glomerular filtration rate. Let me tell you some of the important parts that you should read when you come across, when you read renal system. Please read about the just a glomerular apparatus, as we told. Then about the renin angiotensin mechanism. This is one of the frequently asked question. And about the blood pressure, the regulation of blood pressure. And also see about angiotensin, how it is formed, where it is formed, etc. And again about the structure of nephrons, and very, very important thing is like all the reabsorption of sodium, potassium, all these things, like which areas reabsorb water, which area reabsorb sodium, etc. And again the urine formation and the micturition reflex. These things are actually important, and these are usually asked for your competitive examination. Make sure that when you read renal system, please you go through all these areas. So that's it for today, and let us see next question in the coming video. Thank you so much.